Getting started with your first design in ADS can be a daunting task. In this video, we'll cover the basics of schematic design. This video will show you how we can create, simulate, and plot the results of your first circuit design. To demonstrate the basics, we're going to create a simple low-pass filter. The first thing we want to do is place a component, namely a resistor. Components are grouped by category into what are called pallets. You can switch between pallets in the pallet dropdown. Most of the pallet names are fairly self-explanatory. We can find resistors, inductors, and capacitors under the lumped components pallet. Select the resistor and place it on the schematic. Once you've selected a component, it stays on your cursor. To stop placing that component, you can switch to mouse mode from the toolbar, or you can press the escape key. You can change component parameters in two ways. To quickly change parameters, click on the value you want to change. Sometimes you may need to change component values that are not shown by default. Double-click on the component to see more properties that you can change. Let's now add a capacitor. Select on the capacitor in the pallet. I want to rotate the capacitor 90 degrees. You can do so from the toolbar or using the rotate hotkey Ctrl-R. Again, we need to set the value of the component. Note that we can also change the prefix of the units. If you want to move around this capacitor to make the schematic clearer, simply drag the capacitor. All of the connections will be preserved if you move the component. If you want to move the parameters, click on the component to drag and place the parameters. Let's connect the capacitor to the ground. Select ground from the toolbar and connect it to the capacitor. Remember, to get out of the placement mode, press escape. For convenience in measuring output voltage, I'm going to insert a wire from the capacitor. Switch the mode to insert wire and click on the start point. When connecting two components, the wire will automatically stop drawing, but when we terminate it without a component, we need to double-click on the endpoint. Press escape to get out of the insert wire mode. If you're ever having trouble finding a component, you can find an alphabetical list of all the components in the library list and place from the dialog. Every simulation needs a simulation controller. A controller sets the objectives of the simulation. There are a large variety of simulation controllers available to you, such as DC, AC, S-parameter, harmonic balance, load pull, and many more. There are many other videos that go into greater depth on how to run each of these kinds of simulations. Since this is a filter in the frequency domain, this particular simulation is best done as AC. Later videos will cover more of the intricacies of AC simulations, but to give you a sense of the process of simulation, I'll quickly change the settings. The AC simulation controller is found in the simulation AC palette. All simulation controllers will have the gear icon. Here I have a simulation controller with predefined settings that I've set in advance. We'll need a source component as well. As before, switch the pallet to Sources Frequency Domain and place the component. To easily measure voltage without a probe component, we can use a label. Select Insert Wire Pin Label, enter the net name, and place it where you want to measure. We now have a fully functional circuit that we can simulate. Either simulate from the toolbar or use the F7 hotkey. After you simulate, you'll be presented with a page to add plots and equations. You can create rectangular plots, polar plots, and Smith charts. To plot frequencies, I'll use a rectangular plot. Note here that we have a Vout variable. This is the measurement from the label that we placed earlier. We'll plot V out, which will be the y-axis of this plot. The AC simulation controller automatically sets the x-axis to frequency. Since the axes need to be scalar and the voltage is complex, ADS will ask you how you want to display the data. It's easy to see the low-pass filtering effect using the magnitude of the Vout. It is common practice to set the frequency to a log scale plot. We can do this in plot options, x-axis, scale, log. We have now successfully created and simulated our first circuit. Thank you for watching this Keysight eSoft EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.